So in the series of short video lectures, this one is on bacterial DNA polymerase. This is the usual disclaimer that it is meant for quick revision during the examination time and primarily for educational purpose. And it should not be used or for any other purpose without the permission of the author. Some pictures or diagrams have been taken from public domain websites or popular books so as to make the topic easy to understand. And the credit for them remains with the original publisher. So what is DNA polymerase 1? DNA polymerase 1 is basically the first DNA synthesizing enzymes to be discovered. It was discovered by Arthur Kornberg back in 1956. And it was such a path-breaking finding, discovery at that time, that he got the Nobel Prize a couple of years later, that is in 1959, even before Watson and Crick got their Nobel Prize for predicting the DNA double helix, DNA double helical structure. But soon it was found out that it is not the main enzyme, DNA synthesizing enzyme, because E. coli cells with mutant DNA pol 1, they continue to synthesize DNA, indicating that there is more than, there is some other enzyme which is responsible for DNA replication in bacteria. Nonetheless, it plays a very significant role primarily in DNA repair. Structurally, it is a monomer. It is made up of only a single polypeptide. Its molecular mass is 103 kilodalton. And what does it do? It catalyzes step-by-step addition of DNTPs, deoxynucleotide triphosphates, at the growing 3' end. So you have DNA, growing DNA chain with N residues. Okay. DNTPs based on what DNTP, what nucleotide is there on the template strand. One of the four DNTPs will be picked up by DNA pol 1. These are the four DNTPs, DATP, DCTP, DTTP, and DGTP. And the chain will be elongated by one nucleotide. So you will have DNA N plus 1, the concomitant release of pyrophosphate group. So this is the template DNA, DNA template strand, 3' to 5', and the DNA chain is being synthesized in 5' to 3' direction. This is DNA polymerase 1. So on template, let's say if you have an A over here, so what does it do? DNA pol 1 will bring in a DTTP, and this DTTP will be added here, and the chain will be elongated by one nucleotide. So it adds DNTPs at the 3-hydroxyl end of the growing DNA chain. Chain elongation, like any other DNA polymerase, takes place in 5' to 3' direction. It is very important that replication, direction of replication is always, without exception, 5' to 3', irrespective of what enzyme is involved. It requires a template and a primer. Like any other DNA polymerase, it cannot initiate DNA synthesis on its own. And also it requires a template. Okay, it will take instruction from the template and will add the complementary nucleotide, and it requires a primer because it cannot synthesize, it cannot initiate DNA synthesis on its own. It is a moderately processive enzyme because it can add only about 20 nucleotides at a time. Okay, and the rate of addition of nucleotide is about 10 nucleotides per second. So if you compare this with the main DNA synthesizing enzyme in bacteria, that is DNA pol 3, this is pretty less. So structurally, it is 103 kilodalton enzyme. And you know, when you cleave it by a protease, it gets cleaved into two fragments, one small fragment, which is about 36 kilodalton, and one large fragment, which is about 67 kilodalton, and it is also called as a Kleenow fragment. It is also available commercially. The three types of activities this DNA pol 1 has, you know, besides the polymerase, it has a 3' to 5' exonuclease activity and a 5' to 3' exonuclease activity. So this 5' to 3' exonuclease activity is located in the small fragment here, which is occupying the region at the N-terminus, whereas two activities, 3' to 5' exonuclease activity and polymerase activity, these are located on the larger fragment, the Kleenow fragment, which occupies the C-terminus, the polypeptide chain towards the C terminus. So let us see what is meant by 3' to 5' exonuclease activity. This activity is very important as far as the proofreading function of the DNA polymerase 1 is concerned. As I said, it resides on the larger fragment, that is Kleinow fragment. We have just seen in the last slide. And for example, here on the template DNA, there is a nucleotide C. And a complementary nucleotide G should have come over here. In place of G, by mistake, an A comes here. Okay. So after the addition and before the formation of the hydrogen bond, DNA pol 1 goes back and scans whether it is the correct nucleotide or not. And if it is not the correct nucleotide, as it, for example, in this particular case, it is hydrolyzed, it is cleaved. Okay. And this is what is called as 3' to 5' exonuclease activity. It removes the incorrect base, right? It catalyzes hydrolysis of an unpaired nucleotide at the 3' end before the formation of the hydrogen bond. If the nucleotide is found to be wrong, this nucleotide is cleaved. This activity markedly enhances the accuracy of DNA replication. Because of this, the fidelity of DNA replication process increases manifold. Chances of error taking place during DNA replication becomes minimized. So we have 5' to 3' exonuclease activity also, which is located on the smaller fragment. Towards the N-terminus of the enzyme. Okay, and it is different from the 3' to 5' exonuclease activity. In what way it is different? Because it hydrolyzes a phosphodiester bond at the 5' end of the newly synthesized DNA strand or several nucleotides away from it. So this is the newly synthesized DNA strand, and this is the 5' end. DNA synthesis taken place in this direction, 5' to 3'. Okay. And it will cleave a bond in the at the 5' end or several nucleotides away from the 5' end. Okay, this is difference number one. Second is the cleaved bond has to be necessarily in the double-stranded region of the DNA. It has to be in the double-stranded region of the DNA. Unlike the 3' to 5' exonuclease activity where the nucleotide which is unpaired is removed, here it is the paired nucleotide. It has to be necessarily in the double-stranded region. Okay, it can be at the 5' end or it can be several nucleotides away from the 5' end. For example, shown in this case, this particular bond has been cleaved and then it can keep on cleaving the other nucleotides also. And it with the polymerase activity, the new DNA strand will be synthesized like this. And the nick that you have, that nick will be sealed by another enzyme called DNA ligase. So this particular activity, 5' to 3' exonuclease activity, it plays a very significant role in replication because it helps in removal of the primer. Primer, every time, for example, DNA replication takes place, we have an RNA primer. So that primer is removed with the help of 5' to 3' exonuclease activity of DNA polymerase 1. Thank you.